Welcome to Whisky.com, where fine spirits meet. My name is Lüning, Horst Lüning, and I'm the master taster of Whisky.com. And today we taste the second Jim Beam here on my cask. Yesterday I had the Jim Beam Black Label, 6 years old. And today I have the Devil's Cut, 90 proof, 45% ABV here on my cask. And the Devil's Cut, well, it's advertised, yeah, heavily with the devil in it. Why? Well, there is the Angel's Share. I don't know if you heard about that. The Angel's Share is the alcohol which evaporates through the porous walls of the staves of the cask and raises up to heaven. Alcohol is lighter than air, rises. And over the distilleries, especially in Scotland, on the clouds, there are the angels. And so the alcohol which evaporates goes up to the angels, and that's the angel's share. Well, and the devil's cut, it's the opposite. It's the alcohol or the whiskey which stays after maturation in the cask, in the wall of the cask, in the staves, in the porous material of the wood. And cuts means, well, if you have an undiluted whiskey, it's called uncut. And the cut is, well, the part which was cut off from the whiskey and stayed behind in the walls of the cask, because it does not move up to heaven, to the angels. It remains with the devils. Yeah, there is a procedure to extract this whiskey which stays in the staves, out of the staves. And there's a patent pending by Jim Beam. And I had to dig very deeply into the materia and find an interview, somebody telling something, how I find out how they do this. Well, there is an independent bottler in Scotland for Scotch, and he takes the, well, the residue in the cask, which is charcoal and a few pieces of wood and whatever is in the cask, mixes it and equally shares it on all bottles coming out of the cask, so that you have in each bottle a black residue in the bottom. It says, well, this is something very special, the extract of the cask, additional flavors. Other people go and are doing a chill filtration to get everything out of the whiskey to have it taste better. I have a video about my scientific investigation in chill filtration. This was, well, the first time I became aware that there is a residue in the cask and what to do with it. Well, here we talk about the whiskey staying in the staves and how to come it out of the wood. Well, it's easy. You can think about this and bring it out yourself. Just fill water into the cask, not full, a little bit, and then tumble it over and over and over, and the water will extract the rest of the whiskey out of the staves. And then you have to distill again. No, this is 45% ABV, 90 proof. You have to reduce the original whiskey strength down to this value. And for this reduction, you use that water. That's all. It's quite easy to get this devil's cut out of the walls. How much is it? Well, in a cask, you say it might be a percent leaving behind, and this percent will lead to less than those 2 liters, equally 1%, will give a little bit of influence in the whiskey. Yes, there will be an influence. Will it be big? Not that much. What do I expect? I expect a whiskey which is a little more oaky, a little bitterness, even when the American white oak is quite smooth and elegant in taste. I expect a little bit of bitterness. What's here on the label? Jim Beam Devil's Cut 90 Proof Kentucky Straight Bourbon. As bourbon ages, the angel's share is lost to evaporation. The devil's cut is trapped in the barrel wood until now. Jim Beam Devil's Cut is a distinctly bold bourbon with rich flavor unlocked from deep inside the barrel. That's all. And you've seen, I have a miniature of this, not to open a bottle. Frankfort, Kentucky. No, nothing more. Plastic, I think it's from an airline. And there they avoid having glass because it's that heavy and costs so much to transport. Definitely more than in the black label, and the Devil's Cut is a few euros, pounds, dollars more than the black label. In Europe, below 20 euros. Oakiness, a little spiciness, and yes, a little cinnamon. I like cinnamon very much. And in the back, there's this, yes, this taste of glue. But very few, not much. Oh, have a sip. In the beginning, very little taste, and then heavy impact, strong, sharp oak, a lot of oakiness. Oh, turning bitter, yes, as I expected. Getting everything out of the oak brings you a lot of oakiness in the whiskey. A little nuttiness, longer aftertaste. I had the Devil's Cut already several years ago, and I wasn't impressed, no. In comparison to the black label, this is definitely a giant leap forward, definitely. But to the real bourbons from Jim Beam, there's more to come, the Bakers and the Bookers. This is quite normal stuff. Yeah. So we have the Angel Share, we have the Devil's Cut, and you're able to taste the Devil's Cut, but the Angel Share is lost forever. Thank you very much for watching. Stay tuned, there's more to come, and feel free to share this video with your friends.